At Iceland's most consistently explosive volcano in recent times, Katla, it might appear as though something is happening. Not only has the rate of earthquakes recently spiked underneath this volcano by a factor of 2.5 alongside an increase in tremor levels, but also a notable amount of ground deformation indicating uplift has occurred since June 22nd. With a rate of uplift totaling 3.15 centimeters in only a 12-day time span, there must be a magmatic intrusion ongoing underneath this volcano, right? No, probably not. While this is certainly possible, I don't think a magmatic intrusion is ongoing or even a form of significant volcanic unrest, as despite the data seemingly showing these things, I suggest that something else is occurring which is more likely. Our first clue that this apparent deformation signal isn't due to a magmatic origin is that while it is being detected around the Katla volcano, which is expected, at the same time every other sensor in Iceland is recording the same uplift. And this is despite many of these sensors being too far away from volcanoes with known ongoing magmatic intrusions to be affected by associated uplift. Expanding on this point, the apparent uplift signal was also detected with a similar intensity nearly 1 year ago during late July and early August of 2024. Thus, while bad or noisy data or a systematic error could be to blame, I interpret the apparent uplift to be caused by fluid movement underneath Katla's ice sheet. I do not think it is a coincidence that the aforementioned 2024 signal happened at the same time that the volcano's first notable glacial flood, termed a Jökulhlaup, in 7 years happened. In other words, I speculate that meltwater is also moving underneath Katla's glaciers today, and while not a guarantee, it could result in another Jökulhlaup. The movement of this meltwater are likely why we are seeing increases in the level of tremor present and also why an increased number of earthquakes are being observed. However, it is also true that very small Jökulhlaups and increases in seismic activity occur every summer at this volcano, with July being the month which consistently produces the highest number of earthquakes. Now, it is still possible that an actual new magmatic intrusion is underway, buried beneath a false uplift signal, but the chance of this is highly unlikely. This is why Katla's alert level is still at its lowest level today, green. Another misconception. It is true that Katla is undergoing an unusually long period of not producing an eruption, that being 107 years and counting. And yes, since Iceland was settled, eruptions have occurred an average of once every 45 years at Katla. However, that fact does not make Katla overdue or even more likely to have an eruption than if it had, say, hypothetically, erupted in 1990. When the next eruption from Katla will happen is completely unknown, but when it does occur, odds are the eruption will be highly explosive, rating on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as either a 3, 4, or 5. Such an eruption is most likely to occur within Katla's large caldera, releasing a subplanean or planean eruption column and generating Jökulhlaups. However, flank eruptions, the largest of which occurred at Elgja in the 10th century, are also possible, just far less likely. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.